And I think you'll find that is check and mate, Dr. Baxter. So it is. You know, you really prove rather professional at this sort of game. Well, it is a calculus game, one you will have to think about. It's rather late. I should probably be getting to bed now. Of course, I won't keep you. I hope you sleep well. Good night. Thank you for your hospitality. Oh, it's nothing, really. Good night. Good night. Sleep well. Can I help you, sir? I thought I heard something coming down the corridor. This is a big house, sir. Everyone hears noises from time to time. The floorboards tend to creak a little bit. Yes, yes, I suppose they do. What was your name again? Connor, sir. Would you mind checking for me, please, Connor? Just to see. Very well, sir. Oh, good evening, Dr. Baxter. Up late too, eh? Well, it seems so, Colonel Coves. Everything all right? Fine, I just... I thought I heard someone walking about, so I had one of the staff go and check it out for me. Should be back by now. Ah! What was that? Better go and check it out. He is not dead. Just stunned. I want him brought back to my space freighter for analysis. I want to find out who or what he is.
Indeed, Commander.
Connor, are you all right? Intruders, deal with them. What is that? I'm not sure, Dr. Baxter, but whatever it is, I'll sort it out. There's nothing a good old British revolver can't do. A very well done job. Take them back. We will examine these two specimens as well. For a couple of years now. And is business good? You ask a lot of questions for a doctor. Now, if you're not going to book a room, I must ask you to leave. But I have come to book a room. You should have called. We're very busy. Don't have a telephone. Anyway, how do I book a room? You need to register at the reception. Register? You know, I never really had to register for anything. Of course, when you're on the glimpse of the alpha strokes of the universe, one does tend to forget things. Are you alright? Of course I'm not alright. If I was alright, the whole universe would explode. What are you talking about, man? You're a bit of an eccentric type, aren't you, Doctor? I like to think of myself as a fanatic. What's the tea? Well, if you wanted to grab some lunch, you should have got here earlier. It's gone 1:15. Though I can do you some sandwiches. Ham, cheese, tomato. All three together, thank you. In one big sandwich. If you'd like to come with me, we'll book you your room and I'll get Mary to deliver your sandwich up to you. And as for that, well, we'll sort that out later. In the meantime, I want to know who you are and what you're doing here. Oh, very well, very well. Whatever you say. If you would just like to sign here, Doctor. Thank you. Here's your key. You are in room 11. Please enjoy your stay. Is this going good, Arthur? I've just dealt with another customer, dear. A doctor. Doctor of what? Well, he won't say. He put there with a question mark. What a charming and unusual necklace that is, Mr. Mayflower. It was a gift from my husband. Interesting. Can I have a look? Miss Mayflower and I are very busy, Doctor, now if you wouldn't mind jumping along. Of course not. Strange sort of chap. Do you know where he came from? No idea. I caught him in the middle of the hallway. But he came with a sort of exquisite police box. I'm going to sort that out. Have you seen Dr. Bankster or Colonel Covis? I haven't seen them all morning. There's no record about them checking out. I'm sure they were just going for a stroll around the garden and didn't tell us. They'll be alright. Well, I checked in the library and Dr. Bankster isn't there. What if something's happened to them, Arthur? Like what? They've been abducted by aliens.
Any luck? The bioprocessing was a failure, Commander. This human knows nothing. Like the other two. The Grand Marshal will not be impressed. I have been thinking, Commander, that the Rooted Agent is trying to deceive us. It cannot know of our whereabouts, otherwise it would have been more tactical. However, Lieutenant, I do agree with your strategy. We must be a little bit obscure in our appearance. What are these humans? Although their process was a failure, to destroy them would be a waste. There is a chance that three of them could be useful. So what do you suggest we do? We must reprocess all three of them to carry out our commands. Once they know the military strategies of a Sontaran, they should be able to point out the Rooted Agent clearly. And if they fail, then we shall destroy them, but not before. We will start with this human.
Doctor? Doctor? I thought you might like a cup of tea. Doctor? Nobody home.
Doctor? What were you doing in there?
Nothing important. I thought you might like a cup of tea as part of the hospitality. I've left it on the side for you. It's there if you want it. Is that all? Dinner's at 6:30, so if you want something to eat, come down. It's all right for you to be curious. The TARDIS has that on some people. TARDIS? It's a machine, you know. Ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous. I don't want to be curious, but the fact of the matter is, I am. It's weird. It has a sort of unexpected feel on me. Enchanting, even. What's that? What's that? Oh, sorry. My sonic screwdriver's on the blink. I've been detecting this distinct glint of time distortion, yet I can't seem to figure out what's causing it.
Time distortion?
Yes, you know, it's like a blip in the time gap.
Don't understand.
You know when you're watching something interesting on television and some annoying person comes in and changes the channel while you're watching something? Yes, that's what a time glimpse is. An interrupting shift in the long progress of time. It only takes 1 second, but believe me, that 1 second can disrupt the whole fabric of time itself. So you can detect something wrong with the time tunnel with a screwdriver. It's a little hard to believe, I know, but I can tell your imagination is far vibrant, Mr. Alfred Bridges. Brilliant. I don't want to believe it, but I do believe it. You're like something out of Mr. Wells' novels, Doctor. I'll take that as a compliment. Time distortion seems to get a lot larger around here. You think there's a problem in my hotel? Not a problem. A massive problem. A problem that if I don't sort out, the fabric of time will collapse on itself. Brilliant. I'll get a 5-star review yet. So where do we start? We, a few hours ago you were suspicious of my identity, and now you're telling me you want to help me. I always had an interest in the advancements of science, Doctor. Besides, you're interesting to me. You don't seem as unintelligent and as dim-witted as we first met. I take that as a compliment. Rule number one of ghost hunting. To sniff out a ghost, we have to think like a ghost. Something's coming.
Evening, Mr. Bridges.
Not exactly what I had in mind. Mr. Bridges, how many people do you have staying at your guest house, excluding yourself and Miss Mayflower and your staff? About 15 or so. And do they all use the same electricity currents? Well, yes. All the electricity flows through this guest house's current. And do you supply your own power? Yes. Let's see. How interesting. You think someone's meddling with the power? Well, it would seem so. I'm detecting power fluctuations from my sonic screwdriver, so it's not just time distortion we're looking for. The power fluctuation. It's all combining into one form of energy. An energy that will spark, like that. So what are you trying to say? That there is a form of electrical current energy running through this guest house that you don't know about. Doctor, I'm not exactly a Sherlock Holmes myself, but I have read a lot of crime novels. And in those novels, the detective always returns to the scene of the crime. What are you talking about? Well, just earlier today, two of our guests had gone missing. I figured we might be able to check the hallway where they were last seen, you know? Well, if you think it would help. As you can see, Doctor, nothing. Never say nothing, Mr. Bridges.
What?
Something was here, all right. Footprints. You can't see them, but they're very faint. And my sonic screwdriver is detecting up distortion. Electrical distortion. Aha. That would explain why they're going on undetected. You know, I do wish I managed to get the TARDIS to Blackpool. Blackpool? What's Blackpool got to do with anything? Never mind. I think I made a foregone conclusion, which is...
I think that whatever was here is still here.
You mean it's using a form of cloaking device? That would account for the electrical energy, indeed. I want you to go back to the others and relay everything I just said. I shall try, Doctor. I'm not sure what you're talking about, but...
I think the intruder's still here, but invisible.
Shh!
You never know, it might be listening.
What will you do, Doctor? I'm going to go back to my room to the TARDIS. I have a piece of equipment that may open your eyes, so to speak. I understand. I'll go back and tell the others. Good man. It's this way, Doctor. Ah.
Answer my question.
The Doctor. And where is this doctor from?
Never told me.
He likes to be mysterious, although he mentioned something about Blackpool. Maybe that's where he comes from.
You are being a very stupid man.
That isn't a very original observation. I know that the Doctor is an intelligent specimen, far more intelligent than any primitive being on this planet. He owns a sonic device which managed to use to protect our invisible barrier. He also has an understanding of time and relative dimension, knowledge that is also known by an enemy of ours.
Well, I don't know anything about that. What could you possibly gain from me?
A lot more than you anticipate.
You are not as stupid as you look. Who are you?
You'll have to ask my partner about that.
I'm asking you! Where are you from?
Cease interrogation.
What is it, Commander?
There is an unfortunate error, Lieutenant.
An unfortunate error?
What kind of error?
This intruder known as the Doctor. He knows our ways. He is going to find a way to dismantle our invisibility barrier. And he has got to be stopped.
I was thinking, Commander.
The Doctor has a very good scientific intelligence. He could use that fun. He helped us find the British agent. In return, we did not kill him.
Sometimes do not negotiate with life forms weaker than them.
You should know that, Lieutenant Storm. Apologies, Commander Steiner.
No, my word.
You are not the first to comment on our appearance, and you will not be the last. Nevertheless, as irritating as this specimen is, it will be useful, like the other three.
The other three? You mean you tested all my race before?
Three other specimens came to our advantage, yes. That is all you need to know for the moment. Prepare him for processing.
Now let's see. Hopefully you're not damaged. Centauran spaceship. I might have known.
He is ready for processing. Good. Then activate the mechanisms.
Sorry to interrupt your little party.
How dare you enter a Centauran freighter unannounced?
You know me, I'm the Doctor. I always like to enter unannounced.
Now then, let my friend go or I'll set your computer to self-destruct. Bam! We all go up.
You will not commit suicide.
Oh yeah? Try me.
Obey his orders, Lieutenant.
But Commander, obey his orders.
So, this is the part of the story where I ask the questions. Who are you?
I am Commander Stiver, and this is my Lieutenant, Stork.
We are two Expeditionary Centaurans of the Expeditionary Group 112.
I see your phonetic scientists.
What are you doing on Earth?
Our General-in-Chief has informed us that a Rutan agent is hidden somewhere on Earth. We have managed to narrow the locations down to somewhere within this house.
But even if a Rutan was here, what would I hope to gain?
Destruction of us and the whole of the Centauran army.
You know, I do think if you and the Rutans weren't at war, you'd get on like a house on fire.
Our orders were to track down the Rutan agent and destroy it before it discovers anything new advancements in the war.
Oh right, so you think the Rutans are trying to learn from the humans' resources?
It's not impossible.
The Rutans are a technically advanced species. They gain from learning. It might work.
And the humans have nuclear weapons on here which could wipe out entire cosmoses, entire countries.
We plan to use you, Time Lord, in order to help us. We know who you are and why you're here.
If you think I stumbled upon this area by mistake to help you, you're very much mistaken.
We guarantee the safety of you and your human associate.
And the other humans?
We cannot guarantee their safety. One of them might be the Rutan agent.
Then no deal. I won't have you endanger innocent lives.
We will meet with your conditions. But when we discover the identity of the Rutan agent, my lieutenant and I will have no alternative but to shoot. It must be destroyed.
And once your work is done, you'll get back in your spaceship and fly away.
That was the main purpose of our expedition.
All right, I'll help you, but only to save the lives of others. The Rosans are a very dangerous race. And if they access human machinery, they could be unstoppable.
That's all very well, Doctor, but would you mind getting me out of these cuffs?
Yeah, sorry. There you go.
It seems us and the Potato People are forming some sort of alliance, like the Avengers, you might say. They're not Potato People, they're called Centaurans.
And we do not take kindly to crude remarks by humans.
Sorry.
We have important tasks to perform.
Is everything all right, Vetra?
Good afternoon.
Are you comfortable?
Good afternoon. Can I get you anything? Good afternoon. Is that all you ever say?
My English language is limited, though I do believe I could learn a lot more from you.
What are you talking about?
Ah!
All further investigations point out that the Rutan was last seen in this area, Commander. We shall locate and analyse.
Doctor, is this Rutan, as you say, that dangerous?
Oh no, I don't think so.
Doctor, are you lying to me?
Yes. I was only trying to reassure you for your care.
So tell me the truth. Is this Rutan that dangerous?
This one is. He's got nothing left to lose.
And the Centaurans? Are they to be trusted?
No.
The Centaurans are a warfare race, and I never like to associate with war unless it's absolutely necessary. But they've gave me their word, and the Centauran who gives their word sticks to it. Now, the sooner we find this Rutan and destroy it, the better.
Doctor. She's dead. Been dead for a while. What do you think's happened to her?
It's the Rutan. It must have got to her and accessed her knowledge.
The power, of course. It must be interested in the power.
How can you be sure of that? I'll explain later. I know where it's going.
Vetra.
No, it's alright. There's no need for that. Just calm down. It's alright. Nobody here wants to hurt you. Just calm down, please. Why don't you tell us your name?
What are you talking about, Doctor? It has a name? Of course it has a name, Mr. Bridges. This is a soldier, and it deserves our respect. This is crazy. That is a monster.
Zodak!
I am Grand Marshal Zodak, Warlord of the Rutan Army.
Why does it look like Mrs. Vetra? The Rutans are shapeshifters, they have the ability to change their appearance. Sometimes the little things that are
current through their bodies. Obviously, when Mayflower died, they must have absorbed some of the knowledge about the power of the Rutans.
In this one room, there's the potential of wiping us all out. No wonder the Centaurans want rid of her.
Good. Now we can talk.
The Rutans are a well-established, warlike, clever, technological species. They have the ability to wipe out other forms of life in seconds. They gain their knowledge.
The knowledge and weapons of the Rutan army was dying. The Centaurans found out our ways. They planned to build weapons that would destroy us. We had to find other ways of communicating.
to investigate the matter myself. I have discovered many new weapons on this planet, weapons that will be an advantage to our war with the Sontarans. We will wipe them out. The Rutan army will be victorious.
It's always about war with these creatures, isn't it? Be quiet.
Yes, but don't you understand? Your weapons will wipe out the humans just as well as the Sontarans. You don't know how to control them.
The knowledge I shall gain from the humans here, I shall be able to control the weapons till they are accessible to Rutan forces only.
Even if you do learn to control it, don't you understand? You'll wipe us out regardless. You might think you're gaining an advantage in your war with the Sontarans, but by doing so you're just ensuring our destruction.
One less pacifist race to worry about.
Prepare to be destroyed, Rutan scum. Stalk, don't!
I now have the knowledge. Sontaran military might.
Good. I hope you're satisfied with yourself. Now that you have the knowledge of the Sontaran military, you won't need to act as arms. Leave in peace. Oh, do not like to leave you planets in peace, Doctor. They prefer to leave a signature. I will destroy your world regardless. Then, I shall return to my battle fleet. Good luck with that. I'm the Doctor and I'm going to stop you. No one can destroy the Rutans. Sure, how ways of the nuclear power complex. We've got to stop Zodiac before he starts a nuclear war. What about the Sontarans? Don't worry about them for a moment. We'll deal with one matter at a time.
My lieutenant, killed in action. You have not died in vain, Stormcoat. This is Snyder.
I shall access them from here. This will come in main primitive, but it's all I need to access the warheads. We always set to have a machine of a computer in the guest house. Too much nuisance. So that I can
too late.
I have already gained access.
Then I thank you for doing my job for us.
Steiner, thank goodness you came at the nick of time.
What are you doing?
You're overriding the system, you can't.
Now that the Rutan is dead, I shall avenge my lieutenant and return to my Star Trek.
Wipe us all out.
You can't. It is the Sontaran way.
Commander Stiver, know this. If you proceed, I will blow this house up before you can even reach that button.
Then I shall proceed.
You may think you're quick, but I'm quicker.
You'll die, Stiver, and you will as well.
Doctor, not now, a question. What's that on the back of a Sontaran neck?
Don't push that!
No, push it, you'll be doing me a favour.
Probe vent. Back of the weak spot. Sontarans always have to face their enemies in battle, they never turn their back.
Now then.
Just need to break the connection.
Thank God for that.
Is everything all right? What's going on here?
I think your guests could do with an explanation.
Don't worry, everyone, don't worry. There was a very delicate matter, but it's been all sorted out now.
Doctor, you may have won this battle, but you have yet to win the war. We shall meet again. I am teleporting myself.
Doctor. Doctor. Where's he gone?
Where indeed?
Though I always said he was a strange...